Let's go shopping at Joann's. Welcome to a shop with me at Joann's. Actually, we're going to several different stores. You guys have been asking me about like what paper I've been using, like the large sheet. So I figured I'd just show you, like come into the store and show you guys. And also show you some things that I'm wanting to purchase, but just not today. And I'm just in the paper aisle. This is where their normal card stock is and everything. And mine happens to be in the center of the aisle. And they have so many different colors. Let's see, like, let's pull this one out. This pink. Let's see. This is 12 by 24. So pretty. And as you can see, the price is $4.49, but you can use a coupon. Like right now it's 40% off, so it's not bad. This happens to be a large Joann's, so depending on where you live, the selection might be smaller or actually larger than this. Different craft stores, just to see what they have. Even if you don't have it in your city, you can look online because you can still use their coupons. You can't price match online, but you can still use their coupons. Like right now they also have a 60% off original price items. So yeah, hopefully that's helpful to somebody. And of course I find myself just wondering, what are you guys looking into buying craft wise? I keep looking at the mink machine. I have no reason to buy it, however, I just really want it. I have researched it and apparently you can use your laminator. Like if you have a laminator, it can do the same thing that, you know, the foiling. But I just rather just get the mink machine because I know for a fact it'll work. Let me show you guys. See, it has all these different foils and things that you can use with the machine. This is it. Pretty sure you can use a coupon on it, which is really good, but I'm here with my husband and I know he's not gonna have it. Does anybody else's husband question their whole craft buys when they come home? You come home with a bunch of bags and they're like, what did you buy today? Yeah, that's my husband. He's like, did you need that for an order? I'm like, no, I just, you know, just wanted it. Just because. Oh, and right here, it seems that Cricut has become hip to getting or creating papers that are 12 by 24, and they have actually a pack. I've never seen this before. Not sure if it's new or if it's just now in my area, but these 12 by 24 papers. It says sorbet sampler, so they're like light colors. I wouldn't use those colors, however, it's nice that they're coming out with papers that large because it only makes sense. Actually, some larger papers that you can cut. They have a design on them, but if you, let's see, if you need like glitter or whatever, they have that, which is good to know. If you have a project that requires like a lot of glitter paper, because you know that glitter paper by itself is expensive. But you can actually cut these into two 12 by 24s. Actually, I don't know if it'd be 12 by 24 or 12 by 18, depending on, I don't know what the standard size of this is, but I know you can get two slices out of them, and you can, they have like silver. You guys just have to really look at your whole store instead of just looking at like the paper section. Because these are normal postal boards. And this is actually the kids section. They put it in the oddest place. Well, I guess this is the teacher section, I should say. Right next to these. So what sections do you guys end up in but never really buy anything? For me, it's the planner section. Can you see? Like all the papers and stickers. They're so cute, but I never end up buying anything. I like a very minimalistic planner, and really, being a stay-at-home mom, I don't need a very in-depth planner. I just use like a budget planner, if anything, the most. But yeah, I just love looking at the little sticker books and just everything. It's just so cute. The washi. I can see how people get addicted to this stuff. Like seriously, there's so many things to buy for it. Like honestly, look how pretty these are, right? Hey YouTube fam, so guess where I am? I'm actually here in Hobby Lobby. And right now they're having that sale, that seasonal sale, 75% off clearance. Trying not to purchase the whole store. It is honestly so packed in here. Oh my gosh. And I'm not used to recording around other people, so this is kind of nerve-wracking. However, I still want to show you guys like how I pick up paper and things like that. So here's some other poster boards where you can cut them in half and it'll fit on your 12 by 24 mat. Which is good as far as like if you're doing a large project and things like that, depending on what you want. So they have the glitter just like Joann's did, but it's, you know, they don't have as a large variety of colors. Let's see where else. And as you can tell, I'm actually in the Cricut aisle. That's where that poster board is. However, poster board is all over the store. That's why you had to look everywhere.
Yeah, if you found one, it's gonna be there. Yeah, public record.
This section in the back has the larger variety of colors. So if you're making a large project, you would use these as opposed to using something instead of using 12 by 12. So you see how these are larger. And you see how this is 98 pound. This is good. And actually that's where I purchased all the colors that I needed for the larger than mat Paw Patrol thing that I made for my son's birthday party. They just have like a good variety of colors, you know, different types of brown, shades of brown, different shades of green. However, I'm going to take you to another store that has even more shades, because this is actually a good, you know, it's a good range to have instead of using 12 by 12, you know, sheets of paper and having so many pieces to put together for whatever larger than mat project that you're trying to make. But yeah, it's a bit pricey, I'm not gonna lie, it's a bit pricey. So you would have to do the math to see what would be the best thing for you. But as far as for me, I want the least amount of lines and seams. So I'm always going to go for the larger pieces of paper.
Okay.
And these are all the 12 by 12s, as you guys know, the regular aisle that people gravitate to. Right now they have a really good sale, four pieces for a dollar. However, in the long run, you're gonna be doing more work if you use just 12 by 12s for larger than mat projects. And you may be spending a bit more depending on what colors you're using. And here is actually where I get the large foam boards. This is the normal size that you see at, you know, wherever, like Walmart, Michaels. However, this is the only place that I've seen that has the 32 by 40. This thing is absolutely huge, and this is what I use for my larger than mat projects. I just traced the image out on here, cut it out with my hot knife, and there you go. And depending on what color your base is, they have black and they have white. So this is great. I kind of have to be quick in here because it is so busy with this sale going on. Oh my God. But yeah, hope you guys enjoyed the trip to Hobby Lobby. On to the next store. I'm at the next store, and this is actually called Blick Arts, Art Materials. And this is actually primarily a, like, people that paint would come here. Like, they have all types of paints, brushes, materials to create your own canvases, literally from scratch. You can cut the canvas out yourself, and it's quiet, but then the music is kind of loud, so I'm not sure if you guys can hear me properly, but this is where I get my very specific colors from. If I need certain shades, I'll just come here first because I know they'll have the shade that I need because they have so much of a variety here. And like I said before, you have to look at the pricing to see if it's actually worth it or not. So I'll show you some prices and let you know, like, what, you know, where it kind of stands as far as the price per paper. And I actually have my son here, my little sidekick, with me today. Daddy's actually at work, so he's coming along for the ride. So yeah, they have a lot of sales. They always have the sale where it's buy four, get one free. And if you don't do that sale, their prices are pretty much $3.95 per paper. And they're about, let's see the price or the size. Can't see the size on that one. So 20 inches by 26 inches. That's what I'm seeing right now. And let's see, 19 and a half by 25 and a half. And they have smaller papers and things like that. I like this store a lot, even though I'm not a painter at all. They just have so many intricate things that they're so cute and cool to look at. Like, look at all these different dowels. So yeah, I'll show you some other things back here. And that's pretty much what I needed to show you guys from this store, but it's pretty cool. If you guys have one in your area, you should just check in just to see what they have. They have these papers. These are actually much sturdier. I wouldn't even call this paper, actually. This is like really hard. So here are some other options. Let's see if I can do a better angle. There you go. These are papers up here that you can also use. See, it's like 99 cents, like regular prices and stuff. But these down here, where you see it's like $9, $14, $10, $27, these, I forget the name for this, but you can paint on these. These don't bend. These have no bend to them. So if you have a project that requires you to have a stiff board, but it needs to be colored, this would be the place to go, because this has so many colors as well. All of these are the same, like they have zero bend to them. Then they have some other, let's see if I can do a bigger, like look at that. These things are huge. And this is actually foam board. I just realized that. This is literally foam board this tall. Let's see the pricing on it. And you see it has different widths, this is, or thicknesses. Look how thick this is. I can't even pull it out. And they have black. Let's see the price. $38.99 for the thicker one. Wow, this is huge. I never noticed those. And they have the smaller ones in different colors. This is $8. Oh yeah, so this is where I just came from. It's a cute little store. All these different sketchbooks, drawing books, really boo boo. Okay, excuse me. Huh? And this area right here, for me, I love, because I love looking at different materials. Because these are materials that you honestly can mount and put on your wall as like wall art. Like these right here.
Hi guys, so thanks for shopping with me these past couple of days. This honestly could have been probably three different videos, but I just wanted to stick it all in one since the main focus was the paper. The paper you use for larger than mat projects. I did show you some extra things, and I think I'm going to have a second video just with things I wanted to show you guys that didn't have anything to do with larger than mat projects. It just didn't. So I felt like it didn't need to be in this video per se. So be on the lookout for that. So I went to three different stores. One being Joann's, the first. Then I went to Hobby Lobby. Then I went to Blick. Now, I didn't go to Michael's because Michael's actually is the only store that really only has like the very basic card poster board. So there was no sense in really taking you guys there because they really just had like primary colors and white. So stuff like kids would need for school projects. They didn't have any glitter. They don't really have any glitter paper or like large sheets of glitter paper like all the other rest of the stores did. And or large poster boards that actually had different colors and shades, you know. So that's why I didn't go to Michael's. Now as far as Joann's, you guys have to determine the pricing. I keep stressing the pricing because you have, even though the 12 by 12 sheets may seem cheaper, in the long run you would have to see exactly how many sheets you would need for your larger than mat projects to determine if it's actually cheaper or you should just go the route of going with larger sheets that might be $4.99, but you're doing less work, being that you're not having to piece so many different sections together because they're larger, so you're dealing with larger sections. And also your time, because time is money. So yes, it might seem cheaper initially, but it's really not. Depending on the colors, I guess I should say that first. Depending on the colors, if you're just doing something that's basic, then I guess it's up to you. But if you're doing like different shades, especially glitter, if you saw, I believe it was in both Joann's and in Hobby Lobby, they have the white glitter poster board, and I think it was like $1.99, right? But if you remember, the 12 by 12s by themselves, for instance at Hobby Lobby, are $1.99. So 12 inches by 12 inches is $1.99, right? The card stock, because that's card, they consider that card stock. But the poster board that was the same thing, glitter, white glitter poster board, it was $1.99. So you have to price things up before doing any project. That's the big thing. Also, follow me on Instagram. I actually have a new IG page, so I'll post it along here. And it is The Bree Creates. So follow me on there. I think once I get to like 100 followers, what I want to do is like a live craft with me night. I do projects every single week. There is not a week that I'm not doing a project, whether that's for my own house or for my business. So I do want to reach 100 followers so that I can, you know, start talking with you guys, see what you guys are wanting to see, what videos, what you guys are working on, things like that. Oh, and the last thing, when you're dealing with larger than mat projects, when you start having a lot of seams, I mean, you can only decrease the seams by so much, but if your project is so large that there's going to be a lot of seams, you should just automatically just stick with the larger sheets, because once people start seeing the seams, it just decreases the look and quality of the project. It just does. And it's not because you did a poor job, it's just because when you compare it to like professionals that do like larger projects, you don't, or not projects, because those are prints, when you see those prints you don't see seams, you know. So that's the only thing that I definitely would keep in mind. So with that being said, Thanks for coming with me, guys. See you in the next one.